Welcome to the BricsCAD BIM basic training. In this tutorial videos, you will find out how to use BricsCAD BIM. You will learn the basics, and for that we created a manual for you. You will be able to find everything there, all the table of contents, the intro to BricsCAD BIM, but also the intro to the manual. And if you don't like reading, I will explain to you right now how we are going to handle this training. So first of all, I want to start with the table of content here. You can see that we will do some intros first. We will show you what BricsCAD BIM exactly is, what our standpoint is towards the different approach of BIM. And then we will also give you an introduction to the manual. And we will then start off with the basics of interface, viewing, navigation, and so on. Then we will create a BIM project, model from 2D to 3D, as we love to do in BricsCAD BIM. Then we will import some models, we will model with masses, we will add components such as windows and doors, and we will of course add BIM data whenever it feels convenient to you. And then finally, we will make some basic documentation sets and basic schedules. So I'm really excited to start in. So we will start in with BricsCAD BIM, a different approach, as we call it. I will play a small video for you now. And then we will see how BricsCAD BIM really offers this unique approach to BIM. I can already hint to you, it's because we are a DWG platform and we allow you to really take BIM in DWG to the next level. If you want to read through it, feel free to also download the training manual, which is in the comments below, together with the starter files for all the exercises, which you will see here. And other than that, here you can see the key slides, which we will cover in the video as well. And then after the video, I will give you an introduction to the manual. So see you soon.
Let's examine some key characteristics of the BIM we know today. In this workflow, models are assembled from platform-specific predefined components. While it's not impossible to create complex shapes with this approach, it is best suited for more rectangular designs that can easily be divided into building blocks. This approach limits design freedom, as instead of focusing on geometry, designers can only choose from a set of predefined components. This approach does not fit every type of project, and it is not applicable at every project stage. It also makes interoperability a challenge, as each platform interprets these components in a slightly different way. Let me show you a quick example. While one platform defines a simple shape like a tree in a certain way, another platform may define it slightly differently. The common denominator will be what everyone can agree on, and that will inherently be very simplistic, as it will only contain the similar parts of each platform. You must have heard the saying that the most important letter in BIM is the I for information. BIM is often mentioned as a database, but interestingly, there is very little application of big data or machine learning in the industry, while these technologies are exponentially developing in other sectors. Imagine if you could talk to your BIM software just like a smart speaker. Instead of asking about the weather, you could ask something like this: "Hey BricsCAD, find me similar details and replace all of them." During the life cycle of the project, a vast collection of technologies are used and data is often created in silos. In the early design stage, it is not always possible to assemble a design idea from a set of predefined components. It is more flexible and efficient to model the geometry first and document it straight away. Small firms and designers of complex shapes tend to use 3D direct modeling tools instead of BIM. These tools are great for modeling, but have no capabilities for documentation. Designers are forced to turn to CAD, which creates a split workflow. BIM is most used in detailed design and some parts of construction. When the project reaches this stage, the design geometry cannot be directly converted to BIM elements, so everything must be remodeled in a BIM software. This creates a disconnect between the world of early design and BIM. BIM is then used all through detailed design and construction documentation. The project is usually remodeled for construction, as those firms use a different level of detail. Fabricators and manufacturers of building products must look for solutions outside BIM that are able to support their need for increased accuracy. There's no easy way to connect fabrication to the BIM workflow. These industry gaps create an information loss at each transition from one stage to another. We have a fundamentally different approach from the rest of the industry. We offer a continuously developing workflow that connects early design, BIM, and fabrication into a single process, all based on a familiar DWG platform. We learned from the difficulties of the last 30 years and took a fresh, new look at BIM to offer you a fundamentally different approach. We are the only BIM software vendor that puts AI and machine learning in the center of the workflow. In BricsCAD BIM, design decisions come first, and AI algorithms automate the laborious tasks of manipulating BIM data and the level of detail. We allow you to model anything you want and let AI convert it to a smart BIM. We also apply our advanced AI engine to support the documentation workflow and make it more automated. This AI engine is pre-programmed by our engineers and trained on real BIM models. Designers often stay away from BIM, as using a direct modeling tool fits their design process better. While these tools are great for modeling, they don't have the documentation capabilities, so designers must also use CAD for drawings. BricsCAD BIM brings the best of both worlds together. You can find flexible direct modeling tool and a professional CAD product all in the same DWG platform. This familiar platform can also be an advantage for CAD users who are looking for an easy entry to BIM. Our customers report a cheaper, shorter, and easier transition to BIM thanks to the familiar BricsCAD design environment. Spending less on software, training, and avoiding the performance dip during transition really lowers the barrier to entry. This is the easiest switch from CAD to BIM that you will find on the market. Our solution to the fragmented industry workflow is also truly different from any other vendor. The BricsCAD BIM workflow starts with direct modeling of generic solids, but it continues with the gradual development of detail, powered by AI and machine learning. The same element can be evolved throughout the project lifecycle by adding more and more detail. The BIM elements can be directly converted to fabrication models in BricsCAD Mechanical. We call this the BricsCAD Ultimate Platform, a unified workflow with continuously developing level of detail that connects design, BIM, and fabrication into a single process, all on a shared DWG platform. This avoids the rework and information loss caused by the current fragmented industry workflow. You may be a seasoned BIM expert looking for an alternative, or someone who stayed away from BIM thinking it's not for you. But I hope after seeing this presentation, you will agree that our BIM is for you.
Hello, I hope you enjoyed that video. And let me start with introducing the manual to you. So you will see that I'm using here now a PDF document, which is called BricsCAD BIM Training. And it allows you to read through the step-by-step instructions, which we will give you throughout all these lessons. We have divided the entire training into different sub-modules, and every module has some starter files, some DWG files that should be used when you want to follow the training on your own. We also include figures for extra content, but for an additional context. But if you ever are in doubt, just check out this recording and we will do the training exercises step by step anyways. So you can play, pause, whatever feels convenient. Also, feel free to subscribe to our channel, write in the comments if you have any additional questions, and we will make sure to give you a head start with BricsCAD BIM. So first of all, I want to highlight from the manual that we have some text parts which are indicated in bold blue, which indicate the BricsCAD commands. And we also have some text parts in bold black, which are the important pieces of information, such as a value which you need to type in, or a key that you press, such as the enter key might not always be specified, but most of the times when you see it, it's in bold black. The values are listed in millimeters when we don't specify them. And before beginning, make sure that you set a few settings correctly so that you can follow along at the same interface, and all the settings will be similar as ours, so that you are for sure guaranteed setup for success. And these settings are the following ones. In the command line, we need to put DM push pull subtract on 0. This will make sure that whenever you push pull or subtract, you don't accidentally subtract. Whenever you push pull, you don't subtract from the other entities which are there. We also want to make sure intersect entities is on 1, extrude outside is on 1, extrude inside is on 1, BIM OS mode is on 1, quad display is on 5, and then for on-screen rendering, you want to make sure that anti-aliased screen is set to 3, so that it's a bit of a crisper quality. So that concluded my first introduction to this entire training manual, and let us dive in the next part here with the interface viewing and navigation.